Alrighty, now we can actually start rigging this character. So I did say we were going to in the previous video, but this time I promise we really are. So we're going to start creating the bones and some control shapes to make sure everything works fine. And once you have your model ready, there's one thing you do need to keep in mind. Maya has a very strange scaling system. It's basically every square here is about 1 centimeter. This whole time we've been modeling at about this scale, roughly, something like that. And that's very, very small compared to what we actually need. So just make sure you group your model set and just scale it up to about that point. And you'll know it's the right point when you start creating the human IK skeleton. Okay, now, so onto the rigging. When we have our mesh ready, there's a few ways you can start creating the skeleton. One way is using the joint tool and then just simply start creating the skeleton from here and basically going from there. That's one way that I've used to do, but since the introduction of human IK, you can actually use the skeleton generator to create all your bones. And this will just save you a little bit of time. And I kind of enjoy this because it works fairly well. If you go to skeleton create after clicking that button up there, it will just give you a quick biped template. And we need to make a few modifications to this, but in general, it's just a very quick, simple way of doing that. We also need to rename our character, so I'm just going to call this Farmer 01. And it's important to rename it at this point because if you start renaming things down the track, this thing's going to mess up all your axes and just some of your joint orientation. So it's just a good idea to do that. One other thing I do want to modify is the neck count. I'm going to change this to 3, and that will help me with rigging the head itself. Okay, now the first thing I'm going to do is start blocking out all these joints to match the model itself. And the best part about this is we can just do one side and then we can mirror it onto the other side. So what we'll do is just simply, we'll delete the left side for now, or the right side actually, technically, and then we'll start blocking in one side of the character. And there's a couple of ways to do this, by the way. You can use your axes or the translate tool just to do that. You can even rotate or scale. I prefer to try and just rotate joints to make sure I keep the orientation correct. And the other thing is you can also hold D and move the joint itself without affecting all the child bones. So I'm going to quickly do this and then I'll see you in a couple of minutes. Right, so once we've got this basically blocked out, we are going to encounter a lot of problems with the orientation, okay? And this is mainly because the computer is just trying to automatically orient it in the best way possible. However, it doesn't do it very accurately, so we're going to have to set a few things up to make it work. The only place that it kind of worked is kind of the fingers here. And the best way to know what your axes are is if you just select the root and then go select hierarchy. So I'm just right-clicking, holding that right mouse button, and then select hierarchy. And then I'm going to go to my display, transform display, add local rotation axes. Okay, and you can begin to see where there's quite a few problems here. A lot of it's not consistent. Now, why is this important? It's because for bones, we need to get them to rotate in a consistent manner. So in this case, I just want to say I wanted to select these three bones and I'm making this character kick. If the orientation is incorrect, we're going to get weird deformities like that. Okay, and for the animator, that's not ideal because the animator needs to be able to just go, okay, Z-axis, select these three bones and then Z-axis. So our responsibility as riggers is to make sure everything is consistent. What I like to do is work with the Z-axis when I'm going back and forth. It's just generally just best how it works. That's kind of the way I like to work. And one of the ways we can do this is we can go in and manually spin things around and make things work like that. And we're probably gonna have to do that in some areas. But the faster way to do this is if you go to skeleton and orient joint, just go to the option box, we can mess around with some of these points here. Now it's more accurate to do it this way. Just make sure you go reset the settings and then just leave everything as it is. The only thing you want to concentrate on is this Condary Axis World Orientation. We can go plus and minus just to mess things around and make sure Orient Children of Selected Joints is off because we only want to do things one at a time. Now, for example, I have here just to see how this kind of works, we've got the Y-axis pointing up on the spine. I'm going to do it based on what I have on the spine because the spine's quite consistent. It's working, it's not going to move anywhere. So what we'll do is try and get everything to run on the Z-axis, okay? So down here is actually on the opposite. Even though it's on the Z-axis, it's actually flipped around. So if I go minus and apply, oops. Oh, one more thing before you do go on, you have to freeze your transformations. So what I'm doing is I'm just going to go to that particular joint, not the root, just select hierarchy and then option box for freeze transformations and make sure you have joint orient on. Just leave everything else, actually we'll turn everything on. And it's going to mess everything up, but that's all right, we'll fix it in a moment. What I'm going to do is go to skeleton, orient joint, just select the very top and do that. Okay, and we just apply. Now what we can do is we're going to take a look and see which way we want it. We don't want it that way. We actually want it to be kind of like in this direction. Okay, so I'm going to mess around with these settings to try and get something that I like. So the primary axis is X, that's correct. The secondary axis needs to be Z. And that way we can use the axes to mess around with the joints. Now this is actually still not correct, but that's all right. We'll continue to adjust as we go. Okay, now that you have to sort of mess around with this a little bit just to get what you want, but that looks really good. That's kind of what we're trying to go for. And what we need to do now is to translate it all the way to the bottom. You can try and go orient children of selected joints and just apply and see what we can get, but we're going to get a few problems just down on this very bottom toe, and we need to extend this toe one more joint. So I'm going to go and create another joint tool, just select that and then put one down by holding X just down on that very end. And it just sort of helps with the rigging a little bit, just so that I know that there's that's the ball of the foot and that's the toes. Okay, so it doesn't really matter what orientation this is, it's not going to matter. What is going to matter the most is this particular segment here. Okay, now that we have that axis correct, at least for the top part of the leg, you can see that it deforms right. Okay, so we don't have any weird reversals. The only thing we have to fix is this bottom one down here. Sorry, this toe one down here. And what we need to do is just apply that and make sure we have it correct. Okay, so we can test this out by going to the leg there and go select hierarchy. And then if we rotate on if I deselect that last one, don't want to select the last one, we just want to test this. If we rotate it on the Z-axis, we can see that it works fine. Everything's working on the Z-axis, and if I go Y, well, it sort of works in that respect. We can also rotate the leg on the X-axis. So that's how we get our orientation right. Now, we've got a few problems in the hand. The fingers down here are okay, so based, I'm just going to base it on the fingers, and the thumb is what we need to change, okay? Because the thumb has gone a lot out of whack, and it's just what the computer has been trying to do. It's being naughty. So we're going to make it behave by rearranging that. So I'm going to go back to Orient Joint, reset the settings, and I'm just going to turn that off and see what we get when we move things around. The idea is to try and get the y-axis to point sort of in that direction. Okay, and we'll go from here. Right, so what I've done here is I've kind of broken my rules a little bit, and instead of using the orient joint tool, it's actually messing up some of my rotations there. I've actually gone to, if you go up here, you have the select by component type. If you select that and press the question mark button, you can go ahead and select the bone without selecting that thing, and just select one of the bones and then rotate. Rotate that axes, and I have no idea why it's not coming up. And you can rotate the axes to work for you just by clicking that particular one, and then you can rotate that joint to customize your axes properly. Now, you may be wondering, does it have to be super accurate? And it's like, well, not really. It doesn't have to be that accurate. You just need to get it to the point where it's consistent. So X, by default, X is, because I've used the joint orientation, X will be pointing down towards, and that's kind of what we want. For every other bone, that's sort of kind of what it's gone to. And if you rotate that manually and get it to the point where it looks good, then that's basically all you need to do. That's when your joints actually should work. And because this is an opposing thumb, opposable thumb, we'll be able to get it working kind of like that. Okay, so that's the deal with joint orientation. It is a little bit painful. Sorry guys, it can be very tricky, but just be patient while you're working on this, and then you should be all good. Now, the other thing we need to do is just make sure we freeze all the joints. So freeze transformations, except go to the option box. I've just undid that and turn off joint orient because we don't want to move any of the joints anymore. We just want to get all those scales right and those positions zeroed out. And then once that's done, we can begin just duplicating and finishing off the other side. So what I will do is just quickly select hierarchy and turn off all those annoying axes. Okay, and we're just going to give this a quick test to make sure all our joints are correct. That one's doing fine. Same with the shoulders. All right, now we're going to mirror this to the other side, and the best way to do this is make sure you select the second root, not the center, just the second part of that root, and go to skeleton and mirror joint. And I'm just going to go to the options and reset the tools, search for left and replace with right. Okay, that's basically how it's going to name the duplicated objects. And once you have that, I'm just going to go make sure it's YZ and apply, and that will apply to the other side. Okay, and all the naming conventions for it will be now called right hand. I'm going to do the same with the leg right here. Bang, done. That's your entire skeleton ready to go. I will probably change this particular orientation, but I'll do that in a minute. But essentially, we are pretty much ready to start skinning. And well, not skin, we're actually going to start creating some of the controls, but we can skin just to test this entire model out. So one of the things we need to keep in mind when we're skinning is this is one of the things we have to watch out for during our modeling. We need to make sure our model is correct in terms of its geometry. We have enough resolution on the joints for it to work. And just quickly, I'm going to quickly select all of that. This is in a group, by the way, so I'm going to group that, and then select the bone, and we're going to test this skin out, okay? We're not actually going to skin this completely or do any of the weights, we just want to see what it looks like. So if I go to smooth bind options, I'm going to reset the settings. Max influences, I want to turn it down to 3 because it's just too many. And you can turn colorized skeleton on if you want. It just basically makes all the bones nice and colorful. It just makes it easy for us to see. And then leave everything else as it is. I am actually, the skinning method, I'm going to do quaternion. I prefer to use that because when you're deforming the arm, it will maintain its volume. And what I will do is select that and then apply. Now you see, once we have the bones there, we can actually start taking a look at it to see how our model will work. I'm just going to turn wireframe off and test this out. This is where you can have a little bit of fun and have some, well, you can see we've got a lot of weight problems, but you get the idea. This is what rigging's all about. It's all about bringing your character to life, even though it can be a little bit strange. So that's our arm. We're going to do some of these little fingers here. I'm going to turn off that polygon selection because I don't want to select my polygons. And now I'm going to select all of these bones on the fingers and just test it out. And it's looking good. So we've got good deforming on the fingers so far. How about the thumbs? Hopefully the thumb won't collapse. Well, yes, it's collapsing and just on the shirt there, but in general, the thumb is deforming quite well, reasonably well. We'll have to edit some of the weights there. Legs. Yep. Kick me. So it's looking reasonably good. Few problems on this thing. We actually don't want to rig that particular arm, but that's all right. And the toes, yep, toes are looking great. So in general, you see that even though the computers tried to do that, there are going to be some problems, and that's okay. That's kind of where we come in, the human factors. We end up fixing all the problems the computer has made. So in essence, our model is pretty much looking quite good. Actually, not supposed to be animating that bit, but that's all right. And you can see that it's relatively, with just a few bones, you can start to have a reasonably okay character rig. And as always, it's not going to be perfect because the computer can't tell certain areas. It's just doing what it's being told to do. So we're going to do some skin weighting. But before that, we're going to begin with creating some controls to make things easier, okay? So there you have it, guys. The character rigging so far looking okay. Not great, but okay. We will move on to the next part and then start tightening some things up.